Hello everyone, today we are going to talk about alkenes in hydrocarbon chapter. Alkenes are unsaturated hydrocarbons containing at least one double covalent bond in between two carbon atoms in a compound. The general formula of alkene is CnH2n, where you all know n is the number of carbon atoms and the 2n would be number of hydrogen atoms present in alkenes. Its nomenclature, the suffix ene is given in alkenes. Isomerism in alkenes. Alkenes show both structural isomerism and geometrical isomerism. Alkenes show position isomerism and chain isomerism. Geometrical isomerism. Geometrical isomerism. The isomerism which arises due to the difference in the spatial arrangement of atoms or groups about doubly bonded carbon atom is called geometrical isomerism. If the two atoms or groups bonded to each end of the carbon to carbon double bond and both the groups are in the same direction or in the same side, it will be called as cis isomer. And if you are seeing the two identical groups or similar atoms are lying in the opposite sides of, now just see the two structures of butene where we are seeing the spatial arrangement of an compound. Both the compounds are containing 4-4 carbon atoms, where in between carbon number 2 and carbon number 3 you are finding double bond, but in cis isomer you will be getting both of the methyl group on the same side. And in trans isomer, you are finding one methyl group in one direction and other methyl group is in other direction. And this kind of isomer is called as trans isomer. And such kind of isomerism is known as geometrical isomerism. Now, preparation of alkenes. By addition reaction, alkynes on partial reduction with calculated amount of dihydrogen in presence of Lindlar catalyst, we obtain alkenes. Lindlar catalyst is palladized charcoal partially deactivated with poisons like sulfur compounds or quinoline. In this case, alkynes used to be taken carefully and added calculated amount of dihydrogen or hydrogen gas, and in presence of Lindlar catalyst, this reaction used to proceed. And alkynes used to reduced or used to add up one molecule and give. Now, this is the reaction where you will see alkyne in presence of Lindlar catalyst will be giving you cis isomer, and alkyne if they are reducing in presence of sodium and liquid ammonia, they will be giving you trans isomers. Or if you are seeing acetylene or ethyne, if it is reduced with hydrogen in presence of catalyst, obviously it will be partially reduced to give you ethene molecule. Now, from elimination reaction. Elimination reactions are the reactions in which two atoms or groups are eliminated or removed from adjacent carbon atoms. When they are getting out from the molecule from adjacent carbon atoms, such kind of elimination of that group or atom, it will be called as 1-2 elimination reaction. The first preparation through elimination is dehydrohalogenation reaction of alkyl halides. Dehydrohalogenation means the hydrogen as well as the halogen atom is getting out from an alkyl halide. Alkyl halides on heating with alcoholic potash or alcoholic KOH, it will give you the alkene, and the byproduct will be eliminated as an halogen acid. Such reaction is called as dehydrohalogenation, and it is also an example of beta elimination reaction. Now, how beta elimination? Now we are going to understand. See the reaction. Here we have taken bromoethane. On alpha carbon atom, bromo is present, and on beta carbon atom, hydrogen is present. When the compound is heated in presence of alcoholic potash or KOH, this potassium will take up this bromine to give you KBr, and this hydrogen will be taken up by this OH group to give you H2O. Then the rearrangement will happen in between two carbon atoms to give you double bond in between, and the ethene molecule will be formed. If you are seeing the number of carbon atoms are more in a compound like 2-chlorobutane, the alpha carbon atom in 2-chlorobutane is the second carbon atom where the halogen atom is present. This is alpha carbon atom. This left beta carbon atom is also considered as beta carbon atom, and this one is also beta carbon atom. Now the question is, from which beta carbon atom hydrogen is going to be eliminated? According to Zetzeff rule, in dehydrohalogenation, the preferred product is the alkene that has the greater number of alkyl group attached to doubly bonded carbon atom, and the ease of dehydrohalogenation of alkyl halide is according to the order 3 degree is greater than 2 degree, then and 2 degree is greater than 1 degree. Means the major product of this reaction would be when the hydrogen is eliminated to the carbon which has more number of alkyl group. In this carbon atom, you are seeing there is one methyl group, and this carbon atom does not have any methyl group. So the major product would be the hydrogen will be eliminated from this carbon, chlorine will be eliminated from alpha carbon to give you byproduct KCl and H2O, and the major product would be but2ene. But1ene will also be formed, but in a comparatively little amount. Similarly, if you are taking bromoethane, what will happen? In presence of alcoholic potash and you are heating the mixture, you'll be getting ethene, potassium bromide, and water. Now, dehydration of alcohols. Dehydration of alcohols means you are taking up alcohol, or you can say ethyl alcohol. You are heating ethyl alcohol with concentrated sulfuric acid, and the water molecule will be eliminated from the reaction, and alkenes will be formed. These reactions are also called as elimination reaction. Dehydration of alcohol is an example of beta elimination, since OH group from alpha carbon along with hydrogen atom and from beta carbon atom is removed. The ease of dehydration of alcohol is the same. 3 degree is greater than 2 degree is greater than 1 degree. Similarly, if you are seeing this compound, OH group to this carbon is attached. So this is the alpha carbon atom, then this is the beta carbon atom, what will happen when we are heating this butanol with concentrated sulfuric acid at 413 Kelvin temperature, this OH group from this carbon atom and one hydrogen from beta will be eliminated to give you water molecule as byproduct, and butanoene would be your main product. If you are seeing molecule like butanol 2, if you have taken this butanol 2, alpha carbon atom is this alpha carbon atom, and here there are two beta carbon atoms. So the major product would be from where this beta carbon hydrogen atoms would be eliminated and give you butene 2, and the minor product would be in which this hydrogen atom will be eliminated and give you butene 1. Similarly, if you are taking molecule like 2-methylpropanol 2, where you are seeing alpha carbon atom is this carbon atom and all three beta carbon atom are attaching to this alpha carbon atom, from anywhere hydrogen atom could be released and give you 2-methylprop-1-ene along with water molecule. Now, by dehalogenation of vicinal dihalides. Dihalides in which two halogen atoms are attached to two adjacent carbon atoms are called as vicinal dihalides, and vicinal dihalides on treatment with zinc metal lose the molecule of zinc halide to form alkene, and this reaction is known as dehalogenation. Why dehalogenation? Because halogen atoms are eliminated from the compound. This is the reaction. What is happening? These are the two carbon atoms, and these two carbon atoms are bonded with one bromo atom. What will happen? Zinc will be taken up, and zinc will take up both the bromine atoms to give you ZnBr2, and alkene or ethene will form. Similarly, if you are taking such vicinal halide where one bromine is bonded with this and one bromine is bonded with this carbon atom, you will get propene, and zinc bromide would be the byproduct.